What's going on, guys? Mapricks here, back for the LEGO video. I should stop saying that real quick. But I'm really excited for this video, and I took a break from animating to do it. And I got a Fragile order from Temu. First ever order from Temu. Light keeps going off. And I'm really excited for this video. I hope you guys are too. It's a secret what I'm animating right now, but I think you guys are gonna enjoy it. But let's get into this Temu order. I ordered a lot of stuff and I got it for super cheap because of Temu week. I ordered this on the 13th. All right. I'm so excited. So, I have blocks. It's building toys. Thanks a lot. I am going to peek inside of this, see what it is. Oh, okay. Alright, so this is a LEGO AT-RT. And I actually got four of them. AT-RT. Now on to the more exciting stuff. So firstly, I got a LEGO CH-47 medium transport heli. Alright, I'm gonna get this big thing in front out of the way. This is supposed to be fragile. Look at this box. It's all banged up. Well, it's banged up, but it's a 6-in-1 droid carrier. Why is it so banged up? This, I believe, yep, it's a LEGO Humvee in tan. Humvee or Hummer. I got a black Hummer, and I also got 8 really cool figures. Now, I did commit a crime against the LEGO community for buying fake LEGO, but I hope you guys can forgive me. And I'm going to take out the minifigures and review them one by one. Alright, so first we have this blue 501st Trooper. He has a jetpack print or jetpack strap print on his front piece of armor there. And this is really high quality. What I really don't like though is this big armor, I guess you could call it, and the blaster, because the blaster is way oversized. All right, next let's move on to this 327th Trooper, I believe. Alright, so here's the 327th Trooper. I think all of the figures are gonna look a lot better without this ugly extra piece of armor. So, let's just take that off. And all these figures have a different expression. You can see this guy is very angry, and the 501st Trooper is kind of like tired and ready for the war to end. But the quality of this is really good. This is pretty much a decaled figure, in my opinion. Very close quality, and again, a massive blaster. I'm not gonna waste any more time doing them one by one, I don't think. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 more, and I'm gonna do them all right now. Alright, so here are all the clones. I have the 501st armor left, the 327th armor, and the 212th armor. And every clone has a different expression and face design. Oh, come on. Alright, one sec. Alright, so I was unable to get the 212th captain's helmet off. but you can see this guy has a beard, this dude has a mustache and red markings, and they all have different appearances under their helmets, and that's going to have to be another point for Timu. I'm starting to do points now. So quality, I want to give it an 8 out of 10. Weapons, 5 out of 10. The only good part about these weapons are the DC-17 blaster pistols, which are a little big and bulky. Characters. I love the ARC troopers. You have Alpha, Gant, Dread, and Seven. And that has to be at least a solid 5. Because they could have done a lot better with some of them. And yeah. So up on screen is the final tally. Sorry for all the mess. I was literally in the middle of animating when this arrived, and I couldn't wait till I was done. So yeah, I am going to start to build some of the sets. So yeah, cue time lapse, haha. Guys, here's everything that I built. You guys already saw the minifigures. The heck? But I got this other one with the helicopter. He's fake, obviously. He comes with a radio, knife, canteen, some other stuff, a pistol. So those are the minifigs. Now let's start off with the AT-RTs. By far the smallest builds, and by far one of the most fragile. There we go. Alright, so I got 4 of them. You can see what it looks like with the minifigure on it. I think it looks really good. And you can see the posability. It's going to be very difficult to use these in a stop motion because it's going to have to be very tedious. And I'm going to have to spend a lot of time posing them gently without breaking them. So yeah, overall I would rate these about a 7 out of 10. Alright, let's start off with the tan Hummer. So, it's alright. You can seat minifigs inside very, very easily. Probably adjust this mirror. Oh yeah, this is an illegal building technique, guys, in a non-Lego set. So here you have the inside. No controls or anything. You just sit a minifigure in there. Here in the back, you have some storage. You can put whatever you want in there. Some antennas. A gunner seat, and this can pop open just like in real life. And overall, I would rate this about a 7. Alright, now this one came with a lot of stickers. I didn't even put all of them on. Yeah. You can see that there's a sticker back here. You're supposed to be able to lift this up, but with that sticker in the way, it's going to be very difficult. But you have a little bit of storage. Let's get get some light in here. Get a little bit of storage. A tire on the back, something. Antenna. It's very, very detailed. Let's move my lights in close. The gunner seat. I like this gunner seat better. Can pop off easier. But you get a very big machine gun and a very big seat. Nothing to manipulate up front here. This moves, but that's unintentional. It is going to be very difficult to fit minifigures on the inside. Because only single... Hang on. Let me get out my flashlight. Only single stud wide seats there and here. So very difficult to get minifigures in there. And you do have a stick in the middle. You can see right there. And the doors stop on this one. So the doors stop on like that one. And overall I'd rate this an 8. Now let's move on to the chopper. So what you can manipulate over here is you can just open up the back. This set is very fragile. It is broken on me several times, and this window pane doesn't stay in. It's a very iffy set. You can see on the inside, there's a seat with a stud or a pole. And there's no pole anywhere. I think this is meant for like Call of Duty, Mega Bloks figures. But you can see that this glass doesn't stay in. Pops out very... Oh. There we go, I did it! So yeah. There's not much. I didn't add any of the stickers on this, and I think it looks really good without the stickers. So, yeah. I'm gonna move my bright lights out of the way. Alright, so. As for this. This is going to be an entirely separate video on its own. And comment down below if you guys would like to see it. I'm going to do it either way, but I would appreciate the support. It looks like we get a step speeder or two, 2 droidicas, and 16 battle droids. 6-in-1 Pustion. I don't know what that means. Yeah. Building kit. So, it looks really cool. Oh, also, with the Black Hummer, got this monstrosity of a Lego brick separator. Mind you, this is what a normal one looks like versus the Chinese ripoff. And I like this because it can go over 2 wide spaces. But this is like at least 3 wide, if not 3.5. So I don't know what I'm going to do with it. This one says it has, according to the image, it has a lime green version of this. So yeah. Let me know if you guys enjoyed this video down in the comment section. I will see you guys later. Thank you guys so much for watching. May the Force be with you. See you guys later. Bye.